Devontae Lamar is now dead.
Oh.
September 5th, 2024. May he rest in peace and God bless him. Let's get into it. Everybody's woke now, even if you don't want to be woke. We know about the industry. So, we want to say that this is an overdose. I do know people that OD though, but at the same time...
I do it for my mama. Them long nights, I swear to God, I do it for the comma. I'm Willie BB, no my chest in the jungle. Hey. Hey. Money, home, money, I got commas in the bed. Sunday through Monday, I've been grinding with no sleep. Talking about taking something from me like no weed. Thuggle, thuggle, that my brother, brother. We don't want no trouble.
That car driving make you feel some type of way.
Breaking news, rapper Rich Homie Quan has reportedly died at the age of 34. TMZ reports the platinum-selling rapper passed away at his home in Atlanta today. No word on a cause of death. Rich Homie Quan found success with songs like Type of Way and Flex and worked with superstars like Young Thug, YG, and Gucci Mane. He is survived by his four sons.
Okay, as you see, we don't walk through a whole nother door. Okay, another rapper is what I'm hearing to myself. But I was thinking like, okay, this was a fairly good dude. You know, I remember him. I remember his songs. But I don't listen to secular music now. And I really didn't listen to it then. But then, you know, as time passed, I started listening. And I'm like, okay, let me see if I could dig down deep. And figure some things out. First of all, I wanted to say, being up in Hollywood, there, you know, a rapper, they all get sacrificed. They all get sacrificed, y'all, at one point in time. It's when their number is up by Satan because of the contracts that they sign. They're in this. And then, okay, you can say, oh, Marona Prophecy, you speculating. Oh, here you go with this again. No, I'm just saying, look at the history. Look who he was signed under. Cash Money Records, okay. He had affiliates with Young Thug, Rich Gang. Okay, what was Young Thug and them caught doing? Witchcraft, right? Remember? Remember they was cutting the goat or cutting the goat off head with the blood? Okay, voodoo. I'm telling you, these people are into the dark occult.
According to Vibe.com, Young Thug's attorneys have filed a motion to suppress footage of the arrest of a YSL co-defendant, which depicts the alleged sacrifice of goats during a religious ceremony.
Need I say more? Okay, now let's continue. Let's continue to get into this. Okay, as you see, we don't walk through a whole nother door. Okay, another rapper is what I'm hearing to myself. But I was thinking like, okay, this was a fairly good dude. You know, I remember him. I remember his songs. But I don't listen to secular music now. And I really didn't listen to it then. One point in time in your life, you come to a point of standstill with God, y'all. Everybody, you have to draw a line between good and evil. You have to choose. So if he couldn't come to grips with it, giving up his soul, so they say in the industry, you know, he was dealing with that. So then you get into your vices, y'all. Okay, Hollywood, yeah, you have handlers, but depending on how much money you got, like, you know, if you broke, ain't nobody really dealing with you. So you do have street access. You know what I'm trying to say? So dibbling, dabbling here and there. Okay, but like I said, he has a number because he's worth more now dead than he is alive. You get it? That's what separates these celebrities from us, the real people that sit here and observe this, the rest of the real world. Honestly, I want to blow y'all mind again. Don't forget that he was a bot.
I come from the south, from way down south.
Like, you know, he didn't even make it. Y'all like, okay, or we are all of us are like, yeah, you know, he had some hits and, you know, he was a good rapper and he made it. But in all actuality, in Hollywood, he didn't make it. You see, So what I'm trying to say is he running around with Gucci Man, okay, all of these henchmen, Gucci Man and Baby. I'm just saying the background. Listen to the background. These are industry killers. These are industry slave house niggas. Excuse my French. These are the ones that keep the rest of the slaves in line for the higher. So without going too deep, but going real deep, you guys must understand the rule still applies for the Hollywood that they serve different deities. They worship different gods. Baby in them is with Baphomet. So it is the transhumanism. It's up in that agenda, you know, for the gay. So what I'm trying to say is, if this man is not down, or if he hasn't even made it through the other doors, you have to walk through certain doors. If he can't even achieve enough or gross amount, enough amount of money, he has to do witchcraft. And then you have to do a certain amount of witchcraft, signing these contracts, getting into the music industry first. You automatically have to become a witch. I'm telling you. Unknowingly or knowingly. Willingly or...
Gotcha, bitch.
Unwillingly. If you want that check, if you want that deal, you're going to begin to do certain things. So what I'm just trying to say is, I don't think that he was cut out for it. You know, some rappers are just not cut out for it. And these are the ones that you see that crash out and they end up unalived. Whether it's the industry that got to them, the industry that drove them to do it, or something freak happened, or simply they just got a hit out on their life from the industry because they are not producing. And you guys don't understand, I'm not trying to go that deep, but I gotta go deep. It's a hierarchy. The music industry is ran by Satan, Lucifer, Satan, okay? It's Satan, though, himself. So what I'm trying to say is, he got ancient veins. He has ancient ties and map ties, you know, like the lines in a map. He's connected. So his attachment is for the music, okay? The music, because remember, before he fell, that was his ministry up in heaven with the Lord. He had, you know, dominion over the music. So your works do follow you. Remember the scripture? Your works do follow you. Okay, his works followed him. You get what I'm trying to say? So here back on earth, okay, he has his hands in everything with the music industry. So what I'm trying to say is, these are shamans, witches, warlocks that run these things, that are over these regions in the music industry. They're over these things, folks. So what I'm trying to say, these are practitioners of the dark arts of the occult. These are your Satanists. These are your Luciferians. These are your atheists, balled all up into one ancient, you know, one ancient thing. On the set. And to go through these rituals undenounced to the person who is actually doing these things. They might have you slit your finger, or you got to give some blood. No, these things are real, folks. And so what I'm trying to say is, the man that comes to you, or your lawyer that comes to you, the lawyers are tied up in this thing too. Okay, what is the movie with Robert De Niro? You know the movie, but the lawyer, okay, these things are true. The demon comes in a suit, sits down, speaks to you in your language, it tells you to sign this, oh, we need some of this, your blood, I mean, this is real, and you do these things. Okay, then you go to another room with a CEO and or a producer. Okay, they sit down and talk to you. Hey, well, we know a spiritual way on how to gross or maximize you as a rapper or actor, you know, blah, 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 to make you this, that. Sounds good, looks good, appealing, right? Attractive. Okay, so what I gotta do? Oh, just say this or just sign this. Oh, yeah, or I just want you to, I'm gonna take a picture, sit in this bathtub with this milk, or and we're just gonna add a little bit of semen into it. Or, yeah, this is goat's blood, but don't worry, it's just something that we do, and everybody is obligated, they have to do it. Even though it sounds odd and weird to the person that's committing the act. Through the paper and also blood contracts, also the oaths, that's why the Lord said, be careful what you speak out of your mouth, because your mouth holds power. Life and death is in the power of the tongue. Okay, they have these ignorant people, which are these rappers, the slaves, they get these people and they coach. This stuff is ancient, folks. All they did was modernize this witchcraft for modern day civilization. These all of these things go way back. These are these fallen angels that run, that are over these regions, the principalities, over the music industry. And so they are in disguise, and all they do is set these things in paper form, rules and regulations, the English interpretation, just going with the signs of the times, getting you to agree, to verbally agree, to give over, to verbally speak and commit acts, abomination against the high God, Yahweh, Jesus Christ. And so when you do this, you're abomination, you are cut off, and then the devil could fully use you for whatever he wants to use you for, whatever branch off in the music industry, and then also what type of the works and acts you are now going to commit as a worker of Satan. Now you're a slave, you can't get out. Just like Lil Uzi Vert said, you can't get out. You're in now, you can't get out. Yeah, that's what he was talking about.
Obviously, all y'all motherfuckers going to hell, right with me. So, let's get it. Oh, you already here. I'm so sorry, you can't get out. You're stuck, it's over. You heard the songs a million times, and you didn't even know. That's fucked up, but I still love you anyway, though. It's okay, it's whatever. You still love me? You do? That's why I love you, because you don't judge me. I love you.
You got binded up and cursed up and cut off from the high God, and now you're in Satan's camp. You're in his jail. You can't get out. In the cauldron pot. Okay, so rest in peace, little homie Quan. But this is just another story. This is just another number, and you ain't got to do no gematria and all of that to know what the truth is, because it is not even hidden anymore. It is in plain sight, and if you seek out the Lord Jesus Christ and you seek him fervently and vigilantly and with sincerity and become a good student, he will teach you and show you the way of the world and what is going on. So like I said, this is Marona Prophecy. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe for more content like this. And may the Lord bless you. And I'm just saying, the music industry is ran by Satan. It's an invisible kingdom behind this earthly that we see here on earth, and these people are cattle. These people are literally just literal cattle, just like Kanye and the rest of them, except Rich Homie Quan. He did not make it rich. You mean poor Homie Quan. And like I said, no disrespect. God bless him. I am just speaking the truth, and the truth shall set us all free.